Hi, good afternoon. We have with us today Bishal Sunil, who is the founder and CTO of Rocket Learning. Bishal, great to have you here this afternoon. Thank you for being a part of Project Amplify, which is a collaboration between Microsoft and Accenture to help social tech entrepreneurs like yourself. Bishal, tell us what made you start Rocket Learning. I think this was your COVID baby. Tell us about the team that has come together and what made you really focus on starting Rocket Learning.
Sure, definitely. Thank you for having us here and really honored to be part of Project Amplify. So Rocket Learning was founded with the sole mission of improving foundational learning through all low-income communities in India, right? And this is a stark need in India where national attention is now coming on it. National education policy has recognized that most of brain development, 85%, happens between the ages of 3 and 10 years. So there's a burgeoning sort of interest and recognition that this is a very important field. So we started it right before COVID, actually. We have co-founders from IIT and Harvard and IMA, right, who came together, all had experience in social impact work before, and decided that India needed a scalable, high impact, low touch solution to drive these learning outcomes and learning through communities.
When I heard your story first time, I was intrigued in terms of what the adoption is. And at that time, it was already 100,000 students. This was probably 8 to 10 weeks ago. And today it's 200,000 students, right? And we're talking about kids from the age of 3 to 10. Tell us more about your journey, because you're talking to a set of families that typically are ignored, especially from a tech perspective, from an education perspective. So tell us how you've been able to create this phenomenal adoption.
Yeah, I think thanks for that. So basically, the idea is that you user-centric design is very important, as everybody knows. So I don't think anybody had put all the pieces together. The pieces are government involvement, so that going at scale is possible, right? Second is communities and social work, right? Education and getting trust in these low-income communities is very important. So having the teacher there as part of our virtual classrooms, having other parents who drive the learning of those who are more shy in the group forward as well, right? And having simple technology with a really simple interface that works on everything from a geophone to the latest smartphone, right? All of these things are important parts of our solution that we have sort of brought the understanding into this space, right? So we know that also that at this age, children shouldn't be watching the screen too long. So our videos are 3 to 5 minutes long, targeted towards the parent. Parents are the most important stakeholder in some ways, right? And home learning is something that's very sort of ignored right now, right? So we're driving home impacts through parents in a digital scalable manner.
Wow. You know, what is absolutely fascinating from what you've told me in the past, Bishal, is the fact that you said the parents are now engaged. Typically, I think many of them would be, laborers, and they would, leave their child, to go to school. They had their other jobs, maybe, go and clean households, etc. Whatever, they were trying to do. And they were probably not engaged and had no clue what was going on in their child's life. But today, the family member is actually engaged in the child's development. What do you believe has caused this, for them to be engaged? And what have you seen as feedback coming in from them?
Yeah, that's a great question. I think we have a very important key piece of it is three aspects, right? Which is AIM framework, that's what we call it. Call it aspiration, that the parents need the aspiration that I should be a part of the child's learning, right? And education is important at an early age, especially since foundational learning happens, and that your child can actually get out of poverty. right, and into a better future. So we build a lot of aspiration through media campaigns, whether campaign with Suresh Raina or or even like our videos, promote the awareness that foundational learning is important. Second is information. So small bite-sized videos with a call to action at the end of them, so that they have a specific follow-up that they have to do, and have a two-way model instead of a one-way model, is very important. Video base is important because even illiterate parents can sort of understand what's being done. Play-based and activity-based learning that doesn't have too many requirements, not even a notebook often, is also very important, right? And finally is motivation for measurement. So as I said, behavioral change happens only when you're motivated in the right way and continuously, and you see the impact, right? So whether through report cards that give you smileys every time you send back a video or an image, video compilations, quiz bots that you can take asynchronously, all of these things serve to give that feedback to the parent and therefore the child that this is something that's important and you're doing well, and please go on, right? So we've very carefully created this framework. And I think also an important thing is that it's an asynchronous framework, right, from a tech perspective. A Zoom class wouldn't work for this population of students because they don't have stable connections all the time. And as you said, maybe they have one phone in the household that sort of goes away with the father or mother when he or she goes to work. So an asynchronous model that has low tech hurdles is also very important.
No, I think you've thought through the problem brilliantly, keeping it simple, most importantly, looking at the audience, looking at the practicality of the solutions. And my last question to you is that, 200,000 is a really large number for an early adoption, right? But clearly the opportunity is not just for 200,000, but maybe, 20 million, 200 million, I don't know that number, right? Do you see yourself, how do you plan to scale? And what is the support that Microsoft and Accenture have given Rocket Learning as a part of being part of Project Amplify?
Absolutely. I think Microsoft has been, and Project Amplify have been very, very key to us scaling, right? It knows that, whatever our efforts are, we're able to find the right partners, right? Guidance, speaking to you as well before, has given us some great guidance. And, whether it's on the Azure side, right, and getting architecture reviews or anything that we need is always available so quickly. So our plan is really, and we're completely cloud-based, completely on Azure. So our plan is to really leverage that to deliver a model that costs less than 100 rupees per classroom a year, right, to this to all children in India of this age. Right. So I think Amplify has been very, very much a source of comfort for us because we know that we can hope and dream to scale with our partners behind us supporting us.
That's outstanding. That's really, really, phenomenal. I believe that you have really come out with a solution that is technology based, kept it simple, and helped, helping the world, I think, in terms of making it a better place, allowing these children and their families to feel inclusive. I think that's most important, that they are not being left behind with all the digital adoption that's happening, and really taking, taking charge of a very important part of growth, which is early education. Vishal, thank you. All the very best, and we hope to be a part of your journey as you scale and help millions of families, not just here in India, but globally.
Perfect. Thank you so much.
Great. Thanks.